My computer locks up and won't boot. What do I do? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not signed up for my weekly newsletter, Confident Computing, head out to askleo.com/newsletter and do so right now. I'll wait. The newsletter comes out weekly and covers a lot of tips and tricks and answers to your questions, basically giving you more confidence as you use your technology. So, you turn on your machine and nothing happens. It's actually more than nothing happens. There are several different scenarios we're going to investigate here. The question is, when you can't even log into your machine, when you can't even get into Windows, what do you do? How do you solve the problem? Well, it depends on where in the process the failure happens. So I'm going to look at some of the things to look at, depending on how far you got. So let's assume we have a machine that's working and you're able to sign in correctly. Great. Let's start stepping back from that incrementally as things get worse and worse. For example, let's say you're able to sign in, but then nothing. Or you get error messages that you don't understand, or there's just nothing you can do. You basically can't get to Windows and continue, but you were able to sign in. That means a lot of stuff was working, but some other things weren't. Some things to check are the disk space on the machine, any physical errors on the disk. Network connectivity can actually cause this kind of problem in some situations. Another scenario that tends to be somewhat interesting that Microsoft seems to fall back to frequently when they're answering this question in their support forums is this concept of a corrupt profile. A profile is the information that's associated with your specific login account. If for some reason that is damaged, and that could be registry, it could be files associated with your profile. One of the reasons that I talk about checking the disk for errors is that it then can't complete signing you in. The solution in that case is to, if you can, somehow boot your machine, perhaps into safe mode, and create a new user account that you can then start using. There are some other solutions that get a little bit more, like you could end up refreshing all of Windows or reinstalling Windows, but that would be one to start at. Now, what happens if you didn't get that far? You weren't able to sign in at all. There was no opportunity for you to enter your username or your PIN or your password or any of that kind of stuff. If you get a crash, a hang, a blue screen or something after the Windows logo has been displayed, but before the sign-in screen, that's a problem of some sort with Windows. It could be Windows itself. More commonly, it's a driver issue that's causing Windows to have a failure of some sort. It could be damaged Windows files. It could be malware. It could be even another hard disk issue, like a bad disk as well. The best first step to take is to boot into what's called safe mode. Now, there are instructions on the Microsoft site how to get into safe mode, but that, if you can get into it, will allow you to do some diagnostics like the system file checker. But again, the scenario that could potentially be required to fix this would be a refresh install of Windows or restoring to a backup taken prior to all of this happening. Freezing before the Windows logo starts to get interesting. Then it could be a hardware issue. It could be any number of things. It could still be Windows, because Windows is still kind of loading before the Windows logo gets displayed. They try and display it as soon as possible, but not necessarily are able to. The thing to do that I would recommend you actually do in a situation like that, this is where there's a feature built into the Windows recovery or repair console that really can be helpful. But it's going to require that you boot from installation media. This is something you can download using a different computer, but once you boot from it and you run the installer, of course, don't hit install now. There's another link in the lower left-hand corner of that window called Repair Your Computer. In that, you can then use the command prompt option and run diagnostic tools like the system file checker. What happens if you get a message that says, operating system not found? That actually used to be a lot more common than it is these days, but it is still very, very possible. Nine times out of 10, what it means is that you've left a USB thumb drive, or if you're like 20 years ago, a floppy drive, inserted into your machine that does not have a bootable operating system on it, and your BIOS or UEFI is attempting to boot from it. In other words, it's attempting to boot from something that isn't the system disk, and lo and behold, there's no operating system on that USB thumb drive or whatever. There are two solutions. One, unplug the USB thumb drive and reboot. It should boot into your, using the hard drive. The other, of course, is that you want to be able to leave things plugged in. You'll have to check your UEFI BIOS for the boot order. Getting into that varies depending on the kind of machine you have. It's different from machine to machine. But once you're in there, you should be able to change the order of things that the BIOS will check to boot from. My guess is you're booting from USB first and then the internal hard drive. Change that around. Check the internal hard drive first and then USB thumb drives, and you should be fine. Now, I said that's 9 times out of 10. The other scenario is, of course, more complicated. There are a number of things that could potentially cause a problem here. What I would recommend you do as well is, again, reboot from the installation media using the Repair Your Computer link. Again, there's a tool called Startup Repair. Startup Repair actually checks a number of different things that could potentially go wrong for a variety of reasons trying to start your machine. This is the thing that will check the master boot record, the partitions, the, you know, making sure that the correct partition on your hard drive is selected, and so forth. That is well worth running if, like I said, you get to a point where it isn't either finding your hard drive or it's not finding an operating system on your hard drive. Finally, the BIOS itself, or power on self test, also known as POST, also does a number of tests on your hardware as part of the boot process. In the worst case scenario, you may only hear some beeps. The magic is that the pattern behind those beeps can sometimes tell you what the BIOS thinks is wrong. The problem, of course, is that the beeps on my machine are going to tell me different things than the beeps on your machine. The good news is that there are POST beep code pages, and I've got links to it in the companion article for this, that will tell you what the beeps are at least attempting to tell you. Now, the issue, of course, with a BIOS failure is that this probably is a hardware issue. It may be something simple, but it may require further diagnostic tools to really understand exactly what's going on. Anyway, I hope that gives you some things to look for when your machine won't boot, be it from a black screen at the very beginning to simply not being able to complete a sign-in. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2073. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.